what is murder by your definition? By my definition, murder is the own winning by the victim taking of his life, since the majority of the animals in the meat and egg industry don't want to die. If they get a chance, I am positive they will always choose freedom over be killed. So, it does not matter which kind of species it be. It does not matter if the law say that it's not murder. Because in the time of apartheid in South Africa, it was also not rape to rape a black woman. So, can we stop going to the law, how is a very big indicator of what reality is, and learn to think for ourselves a little bit, or want we to be little automatons who don't think for themselves and only follow the political correct way, only following the safe way, only following the populist way? Is that to be true and be honest? And I understand people like Butterfingers, Isaac Butterfingers, you know, that weird guy with that beard, I talks more about veganism than majority of the plant-based community, or John Rogan, don't like to hear it. I have also a video about John Rogan. There's a song that I've actually made where I call him Uncle John Rogan, because he is just like Uncle Tom's and Uncle Sam, a propaganda mascot of commercializing. It's not an honor to be called a house nigger. It's not an honor to be called an Uncle Tom. And I also say it is not an honor to be called an Uncle Sam, a propaganda mascot of patriarchy. So, reality is harsh. All through past three stages. First, it is mocked and ridiculed. Second, it is violently opposed. Because people don't like to change. People like to be a little fuckwit, conservative nitwit. Don't want to change their society cult, yours. Traditions. But traditions, beliefs and habits are not so good indicators of being right or what being wrong. You know, slavery was also tradition, belief, habits. And people have done it for long times. But it does not make it good. If you are not the victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not the victim, things look a lot different from that. Because if you are not the victim, you can be the most evil tyrant you ever can imagine. You can be Adolf Hitler, who don't watch the situation from the victim's point of view. You can be Josef Mengele. You can be Winston Churchill. He was a very bad man. Yes, he was not bad to Europeans, but he was a racist first class. And if you not believe me, check out what he have done to Indians and what he have done to Africans and his cohorts. Maybe you get another point of view of this wicked man. You can also be a cruel bastard like Hikihoyo. Again, if you are not a victim, things look a lot different from heaven. But if you are the victim, there's no excuse for what the victimizers do to you. And that's what I try to let people understand. I try to learn people to watch situations from the victim's point of view instead of the victimizers. Because the victimizer's mindset is what creates all the problems on this planet. This is the mindset of Mike the Right from You proved to me why I should to be kind to you. You are displaceable. You are just an object. I can do whatever I want to you. Prove to me that you are more intelligent than I think you are, so that I can maybe respect you. Prove to me you are equal to me. And if you are gonna do, you are just a two and I do every way which I can do with you. That's the mindset of the victimizer. I don't wanna hear any of your excuses. I wanna that you change your evil ways and go vegan. If you are change your evil ways, I don't wanna to hurt you. But if you are not changing your evil ways, maybe shut up. Check out my logical fallacies list, and maybe I won't make more. Because all excuses, all arguments flesh eaters use to eat the animals, you can use to eat people. A particular eye, because my IQ is higher than of the most people. So I can eat a lot of people who are less intelligent than me, using the appeal to intelligence fallacy. I can also use the appeal to futility, because I am faster than most people, and therefore I am more capable of chasing you down and put a knife in your throat if I want. I am not a very muscular guy, but I am very tall and I am very fast. This what I have, not in muscle, I have in speed. Never use arbitrary criteria to defend your positions. Because if you use that in a law room, you will be annihilated. Remember that. When you are debating vegans, you are in the oppressor's position. The vegans are in the liberationist position. So your position needs defense. The vegan does not need defense, because we are true and righteousness, not self-righteousness, because we do offense the other living beings. How you take out of the scenario to let us look despicable. Stop playing your mind games. This 2018. Give it up. Give it up the consumption of dismembered corpses of murdered, raped and tormented innocent living beings. My words are harsh, but it does not mean that I am wrong. I am not sugarcoating the truth for you. Simple. Because I am not a politician. And there are many vegans that will do it for you, but I am not the one. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinters away and the truth becomes visible.